The use of chemical weapons, is that a red line in your mind for whether NATO should at least intervene to protect civilians in some form in Ukraine?
I think that it should be, Chuck. And I think that we in the West, the United States and NATO, we need to stop telling the Russians what we won't do. We need to be very clear that we are considering all options, that the use of chemical weapons is certainly something that would alter our calculation. And we need to understand that, you know, we shouldn't be in the business of, some have called it self-deterrence. Mm-hmm. Putin's actions so far have demonstrated, first of all, that the Russian military is nowhere near as capable as the world perhaps thought it was, probably not as capable as Putin thought it was. And they need to understand that if the brutality here increases, the United States will contemplate and consider every possible range of actions along with our NATO allies. And I think.
So Liz Cheney shocking the world for the first time ever. She thinks, hey, maybe we go to war. Maybe there's an excuse. Maybe there's a rationale. And in this case, it would be the use of chemical weapons, which, by the way, earlier in this month, Russia accused Ukraine of harboring chemical weapons. Russia, I should say, and then also former lefties on YouTube accusing them of preparing to use chemical weapons, which US officials believe to be a false flag strategy of Russia, justification to use its own chemical or biological weapons. Joe Biden has warned that Russia would endure severe consequences if chemical weapons were unleashed. They have not been more specific than that. Liz Cheney has been. She wants them to be severe and military. By the way, we're like a week and a half into the biolabs thing, and thus far, no chemical weapons use by any side, which is exactly what we would want. But Francesca, what do you think about Liz Cheney there?
Oh man, I mean, it's just kind of adorable because it's like, oh, you're still your daddy's girl. Like, you're still a Cheney after all these years. You want to go to war so bad, don't you? Oh, you do. And like, oh my God, and this has been, it's not funny, but it's been rolling through my mind this entire time. We know what Trump would be doing right now if he were president, effectively nothing. You know, blaming Ukrainians for them being bombed and killed. But we also have to think about what Bush would do. And Bush Cheney team would be in Ukraine right now. Consequences be damned, committing however many soldiers to the on the ground. And you know, we would be in for a long quagmire. As you know, you hear her saying, she's like, the Russian army is not even that strong. Nah, that's a Cheney. That's a little neocon in there being like, ooh, I think we can take them. Great, yeah. You know what I don't think? I don't think Putin is a stable actor. I don't think he's a reliable one. And I would not bet on him not using nuclear weapons. And like when someone wants to use chemical weapons, is your response like, cool, let's send our people in there? I don't know. Yeah. I that's not the kind of leader I would be. But I do understand, this is the entire last point, the entire thing with trying to exercise a certain amount of restraint. No matter which party is in power, the opposition party will always say that they look weak, you know, always say it. And it happened under Obama. He did put a red line and then he put it to Congress when it came to Syria and their use of chemical weapons. And Congress, in fact, said no. So it's an interesting strategy. I don't know if Congress would still say no, at least not the Senate. But yeah, putting it actually to a vote with our elected representatives, that could be an option.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. I've been trying to get a sense of that. And we are, because of the stakes, we're pointing out those who we feel are actively encouraging a push for war. But I am not doing so because I believe that they're widely representative, whether they're, you know, reporters or elected representatives. I do think that thankfully, the nature of this conflict, the push for war is far more muted than it was in all of the other ones, I think, because it's always been there. I don't think that there are many politicians that are hot for us to get directly involved. You have like John Kennedy, occasionally Lindsey Graham, you have some pundits,
Kissinger.
Sean Hannity, Kissinger, of course. He doesn't even know what
and
the conflict
then
is.
The entire press corps.
Yeah, and the entire press corps, unfortunately. And look, the interesting thing is you point out, I think rightly, her comment about the Russian military. Like thus far, they do seem to be having far more trouble. We've been reporting on that regularly. But we're reporting that because we believe it to be reflective of the situation on the ground, not because like, so let's get in there and let's do this thing. But it really does feel like that with Liz Cheney. As you said, I think we can take them, but let's finesse that a bit. That's Liz Cheney saying, I think we can take them. And if we can't, ain't gonna affect me. I'll make some money off it either way because we'll sell the weapons. I'm never gonna be within 3,000 miles of it. If they nuke a few cities, I'll stay out of city centers and I'll be perfectly fine. We are focusing on the stakes as they apply to as many people as possible. Those who would benefit from the war are the most insulated from it on both the American and Russian sides.
Yes, 100%.
Yeah. Now, we wanna let you know about some other updates of what's been going on over the past few days on the ground, including that, and again, grains of salt, as always. We're almost a month into this, massive grains of salt on anything that has not been confirmed by multiple parties. Ukraine's foreign ministry accused Russia of forcibly relocating thousands of children from the eastern Donbas region to Russia. They said almost 2,400 children were taken from their parents on a single day, March 19th. That claim could not be independently confirmed. And it's a big one, one would want it to be, but that is what they are saying. In addition, Russian forces apparently bombed an art school in Mariupol that was sheltering around 400 civilians. That follows up the theater that was bombed, where well over 1,000 civilians were sheltering. Seems like kind of a pattern, potentially. A mall was just destroyed, killing at least 8 people. And there's video going around. In fact, I saw CNN right before we went live was using it. I considered it to be difficult to 100% confirm exactly what was happening in the video, so we chose not to use it. But it appears to show protesters, peaceful protesters in Kherson, being fired upon by Russian forces. There is some video of people that had been bloodied. It is not clear if they were just close to flashbangs or if there was active live ammunition being used on the protesters, which is why we are deciding to slow roll actually using it. But we've been worried about that. There's been a lot of intimidation of peaceful protesters in the cities that have been taken over by Russian forces, Francesca. If this is signaling a willingness to disperse these crowds with force, that is a scary change for Russia to be making.
Yeah, absolutely. And they're gonna continue to do that as there's more and more dissent within Russian society. And again, as information cracks actually leak through and Russians understand what's going on. I mean, I think especially if this is being sold to the Russian people as a targeted military, exercise or just like strike or operation, then that's the kind of thing that should be done in a couple weeks, correct? Right? It shouldn't be a prolonged war if it's not actually a war, but here it is, it's prolonging. The thing I'm gonna say is also, I think it's very interesting that Putin doesn't really have a line as to what he wants with Ukraine. This is not, I'm going to save the Ukrainian people. This is not even, you know, sort of that, you know, American veneer of benevolent intervention as we often do. This is just, nah, it's mine, I want it.
Yeah.
And that's it. And it because if he really was concerned about the Russian minorities or Russian speaking minorities in the eastern provinces of Ukraine, then why are you kidnapping children? Why are there also reports of people being forced into labor camps or disappeared once they reach the Russian side? Maybe Russia's actually not much better. If you're open firing on your protesters, then what are we doing here? What are you spreading? It's definitely not freedom or civil rights or whatever democracy, definitely not democracy.
Yeah.
But it's just interesting to see. And it's just it's mine and I want it and it's mine now.
Exactly. Yeah. And look, when we say what he wants, there's like different levels of want. Want can mean is serious about pursuing rather than we believe is reflective of a desire inside of his heart. The idea that he cares about Russian speaking people in Ukraine. He's got $200 billion and he murders his political opponents. He doesn't care about regular people in literally any context.
No.
But he might be willing to do certain things in advance of the supposed goal that means nothing to him personally. He seems to want to do maximum damage in pursuit of getting things, with the things possibly being those regions, more control of the Ukrainian government, demilitarization, God only knows. And the question is going to be how far he's willing to go, how barbarous he's willing to be before hopefully making some sort of deal. And even a deal itself isn't necessarily, like, one of the fears I think on the Ukrainian side is if they take one of these deals, especially if they like transfer over, you know, the contested regions, for how long? How long does that stand?
Yes.
Do you then just have Russian forces that move into and permanently camp in those areas and then they invade again in a year? There's a lot of fears about where this could go long term. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.